adrenalectomy, left laparoscopic indications. The presence of cortical or medullary tumors of a benign nature is a well-established indication for unilateral laparoscopic adrenalectomy. These tumors may be functional and produce cortisol, aldosterone, catecholamines, and rarely testosterone and other sex hormones. In many cases, the tumors are non-functional and are removed because of the concern for cancer. In these situations, the adrenal mass is frequently found during abdominal imaging done for unrelated indications. THs, so named adrenal incidentalomas, should be removed if they have a cross-sectional diameter 4 cm or greater, or if they are proven to be functional. Patients with non-functional adrenal masses less than 4 cm should be followed with periodic imaging to monitor changes in the size of the mass. A benign adenoma on CT is typically a homogeneous left adrenalectomy. The patient is placed in a lateral position with the left arm crossing the chest and supported on a padded arm board, figure 1. The right arm is placed on a separate arm board and an auxiliary roll is used. Liberal padding is used between and around both arms. The abdomen and flank area should be exposed and the left knee flexed, with a padding of blankets or pillows between the legs. Operative preparation: the patient's hair should be removed with electric hair clippers with minimal trauma to the skin. Incision and exposure: for a left adrenalectomy, the surgeon stands on the patient's right side, figure 1A. The camera operator stands to the left of the surgeon and the assistant on the left side of the patient. A 10mm 30-degree laparoscope is placed either above the umbilicus or in the left lateral mid-subcostal position in the mid-clavicular line just above the level of the umbilicus using the open technique of Hassan as described in plate 91. The abdominal space is inflated to 15 cm of pressure. The laparoscope is introduced, and all 4 quadrants of the abdomen are examined for abnormalities, safety of other planned port sites, and evidence of any metastatic disease. A 5mm port is placed in the far left lateral subcostal position and a 5mm port is placed just to the left of the midline through the upper rectus muscle sheath just to the left of the round ligament. This reduces the chance of lacerating the epigastric artery, which might require suture ligation. These ports are in a line about 2 finger breadths or so below the edge of the costal margin. A third 5mm port is placed in the anterior axillary line midway between the costal margin and the iliac crest, figure 1B. Details of procedure: the operative exposure of the left adrenal is shown first. The splenic effervescence of the colon is mobilized using an ultrasonic device so as to expose the kidney. The dissection is continued surrounding the lesser sac is entered by separating the greater omentum from the splenic flexure and transverse colon. It is not necessary to mobilize the spleen. The lesser sac is entered through the pancreas identity. In some patients, it is necessary to dissect the entire lateral border of the adrenal gland in order to mobilize it and retract the gland superiorly, thus permitting identification of the adrenal vein. The inferior attachments are divided. Finally, avascular lateral and superior attachments are dissected. Figure 7. The gland is now free for extraction in a laparoscopic retrieval bag. Figure 8. The technique for extraction is described under laparoscopic right adrenalectomy. See plate 149. The tumor bed is then inspected for any evidence of bleeding and any additional hemostasis obtained. The retraction on the pancreas is released and it is returned to its normal positio. Postoperative care if the patient does not have a pheochromocytoma, the orogastric tube and Foley catheter are removed in the postoperative recovery area. Intravenous fluids are administered and a clear liquid diet is ordered. Antibiotics are discontinued within 24 hours. Vital signs are monitored every 4 hours. The hemoglobin is checked on postoperative day 1 and the diet advanced. The patient is discharged on postoperative day 2 to 3. If the patient has a pheochromocytoma, the patient will usually be in the ICU. Monitoring of urinary output with a urinary Foley catheter is required. In addition, blood pressure is monitored with an arterial line. The patient is transferred from the ICU when stable and the diet advanced. For patients with a functional tumor, discussion with the endocrinologist about resumption of preoperative medications is helpful.